today I wanted to talk about transferring your ideas and thoughts to campus. And this can go with any creative field, whether you're a chef or an interior decorator or a sculptor or a jeweler. We all encounter this issue where sometimes it's a struggle to get our ideas and thoughts from our head to a finalized product or a finished product. So I recently, that fear and anxiety kicked in for me. I'm working on a project and I just kind of felt like I knew what I wanted to do, but every time I put the paintbrush to canvas, it just was not hitting the mark. So I backtracked and I started doing some of the techniques and ideas that I suggest other people to do. And the ball started rolling for me and it sparked new things. And I think that's a beauty of, you know, gathering the inspiration is that it can take a new path than what was in your mind originally. So let's get started. I am working on a series of paintings. And I don't believe I've done such a large amount of paintings all at once. Something kicked into me. I was thinking about, what will people like? What will people enjoy? And I had to step back and realize I needed to paint and do what I love. So I struggled with the color palette and then I realized, why am I struggling when I know what my favorite colors are? Why don't I just start with those and go from there? So I always, you'll see me a lot of times in my classes, have these African baskets, are really heavy duty, and I like to just compile things that inspire me, whether I'm working on a class or a project, and put them all into here. So I'm gonna start taking out some of these elements just to show you. It can be, you know, very random. I have, found objects from my house. I have, I started working on my palette. I have photographs that I have found online and also ones I've taken. I found some handmade papers. This is some of my, little patterning and mark making. I have my business card to kind of reflect. I love this color, this Kelly green or emerald green color. Anything that stood out to me that I was like, oh, I love that. It just, this handmade palette just brings so much joy. When fear and anxiety kicked in, I realized I needed to slow down. And that's where the sage and the Palo Santo made me think of, meditating and just taking time for myself and not feeling like I need to rush the process. Natural environment. I loved the colors in this malachite and this carnelian here, I believe it is. My natural pigments here, I love this, red ochre color that I really wanted to include. And then some ribbon, a picture of my daughter from a while ago where she's in this just beautiful hand-painted, almost like kimono look that just reminds me of, what's important. And then just her beautiful creativity in it. And I loved this photo. And sometimes you don't know why you're picking things. Sometimes you just grab them. And that's what this process is. Not thinking about it, and I'm not trying to make it cohesive. I'm just starting to grab things that are inspiring to me. And that's around my house. It's things I've made, things I found on Pinterest, things I've cut out of magazines. So it's a mix of my own. And you've seen many people do inspiration boards, so that can transfer to an inspiration board. But what I love about this bowl is that I can just bring it around with me. And it can just kind of live and move around with me as I move around my studio or even my house. And then the next thing I love to do when I'm really stuck on a color palette is go to your local paint store. I went to one that had some Benjamin Moore colors, which I love. And I just went through the swatches and picked my favorite colors. I was not thinking about what looked good at the time. I was just going through and saying, I like this, I like this. And then I had a pile of swatches that I just kind of put to the side that maybe I'll use for another project. And then I started narrowing down my palette. And I found, you know, it really follows my palette that I love, my clothing, my decor. I even had, I pulled these out randomly, and then my color of my pillow is pretty much the same color. So, you know, there's inspiration all around you, especially in your own space. And then after I gathered this color palette, I created my color swatches. I picked out some soft pastels with these colors. And then, you know, everything else followed. I really want a mix of that black and white and this neutral color with these really bright pops and jewel tones. So these really nice earth tones, and then this deep dark black with these really, really bright, rich, vibrant jewel tones. So what do you do after you've gathered this color palette? Then you work in your journal or work on little minis. And I've done these in my class before. But the reason is they are so, so powerful, to start playing with a palette, because you start to know right away if it's a palette that you like or if you don't like. So I absolutely jump right into these. You can do these in your journal as well. But I started playing with the colors and playing with them side by side. You know, maybe I liked the green, blue, and yellows, but I didn't like the pink here or just the warms here. So, you know, I'm starting to experiment with my palette to make sure it's something I love before I move to the big pieces. And that will take away a lot of your stress and anxiety, especially if you feel completely just frozen. And that's where I was. I was at that point of just feeling almost anxious. And, you know, I had all this in my head and all this energy, and I just couldn't quite nail down what it was. And by going to my color store, by then finding elements in my house that match that color palette, and then starting to create, it really helped me get going in the process. Another thing that I love to do, you know, if I have an idea or theme in mind for my color palette for my series or for my course, I like to get books that inspire me. And you can just go to your library or, you know, borrow from friends or, you know, purchase some on Amazon and share. But this book, True Colors, you know, I had the idea of a combination of textile design as well as natural elements. And this embodied everything to me. This patterning, you know, hand-dyed things, these beautiful black and white marks. I want to have, you know, a black and white kind of theme with these really vibrant, vibrant colors, along with this really natural, like, red ochre coming through. So, you know, this book truly just, you know, took it to another level for me. So, you know, podcasts, books, they really can help you to move forward in the process. So I hope some of those ideas help you if you feel stuck, uninspired, or fear and anxiety kicks in, or you just can't get your thoughts to the page in the way that you want. But always, you know, have fun, play, and I encourage you to just, you know, follow those curiosities.